Okay, let me remind review you again about the math induction or the recursive definition of the factorial. Okay, suppose you want to find the 5 factorial. 5 factorial can be written in terms of 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3, 2, and 1, right? And actually, you can write 5 factorial in terms of 5 multiplied by 4 factorial. And 4 is the smaller problem, right? Smaller problem of 5. This is a smaller, that is 4 factorial. In order to solve the factorial function, right, you have to start from 5 factorial. And then once you buy it to the function factorial, you can get return 5 multiplied by 4 factorial. And then 4 factorial, it can be bound to the 4 will be bound to the formal parameters in the function factorial, and then it will return 4 multiplied by 3 factorial. And for 3 factorial, 3 will be 3 multiplied by 2 factorial. And for 2 factorial, it will be 2 multiplied by 1 factorial. And 1 factorial, it is a basic step, right? And return 1. So the result of 1, right, will return to 1 factorial. And you can get 2 multiplied by 1. That is 2. So 2 will return to 2 factorial. 2 factorial will be equal to 2, so it will be 3 multiplied by 2. That is 3 factorial, which is 6. And 6 multiplied by 4, it will be 24. 24 will return to 4 factorial, and so on, until you can get 5 factorial. 5 factorial is 5 multiplied by 24, which is 120. And 120 will return to main, right? Main here. When you call factorial I here. Okay? So in the factorial function, we can call this as a factorial prototype. And when you call it from main function, this is a function call. And if you declare the concept of the factorial, this is a function declaration. And this one is the base case. This one is the recursive step or recursive case. So it's pretty easy if you write a program by using the recursive function. But you need to know the math induction concept of the function. Okay, this is for the factorial function. And this is the list of the value of from 0 factorial until 21 factorial. Okay, the next, do you know the Fibonacci function before? Have you studied Fibonacci function? Fibonacci is a French mathematician. His full name is Leonardo Bagnacci, Leonardo of Pisa, or Leonardo Bigallo Pisano. This is his full name, right? Oh, he's not a French, he's an Italian mathematician from Republic of Pisa. Do you know the word Pisa, right? This city, okay? He is the most talented Western mathematician of Middle Age, and he has his own function we call Fibonacci. Fibonacci theory is like this, right? If you start from the index 0 is 0, the value of 1. Zero, one, two. What's happened? Okay, when I ask to find the Fibonacci 5, you have to return 5. You can use Fibonacci in many applications. For this example, if you want to find, this is a golden ratio, right? Maybe you will know about it in the future. And right, if you start from 1, 1, the square 1, you will get 2, square of 2, 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 5 is 13, and so on. So what does it mean by the Fibonacci? If you want to find the value of Fibonacci 5, you have to 5 is equal to 3 plus 2. Okay, so think like this. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. 2 plus 3 is 5. 3 plus 5 is 8. And so on. This is the concept or the function of Fibonacci. So if you want to write the formula for the Fibonacci, it will be like this. Fibonacci 0 is 0. Fibonacci 1 is 1. Fibonacci n is Fibonacci n minus 1 plus n Fibonacci of n minus 2. If you want to calculate for the Fibonacci number by using if it is not allowed to use the recursion, what shall we do? This Fibonacci function will be easily written in terms of the C programming. Okay, you can use recursion. That is not a problem. Okay, you can use like this Fibonacci, right? And then you have the best case. If n is equal to 0 and n is equal to 1, right? Return n. And the recursive step is return Fibonacci n minus 1 and n minus 2. So this is the concept of Fibonacci if you use recursion. That is very easy. But in the past, if you don't have the concept of the recursion in computer programming, it will be difficult to find the result of the Fibonacci number. This is my question. How can we write a program in order to solve the Fibonacci number without recursion? Okay, this is the structure. Before we go to the programming, right, I would like to finish this slide first. Okay, for the Fibonacci number, right, if you want to find the Fibonacci 3, you have to find Fibonacci 2 and 1 first. But for 1, you can get the result easily. But for 2, you need to find Fibonacci 1 and Fibonacci 0. But Fibonacci 1 is equal to 1 and Fibonacci 0 is equal to 0. And this one will be 1. And Fibonacci 2, 1 plus 1 is 2. Fibonacci 2 is 2. Fibonacci 1 is 1. So Fibonacci 3 will be 3. That is 2 plus 1. This is a Fibonacci. Okay. So, okay. Let me try to write a program. Okay, if you want to find the Fibonacci, it is very easy, right? You can just simply, if number is equal to 1, or use double vertical bar, number is equal to 0. Okay, it will return number. Am I right? Otherwise, the induction step will return Fibonacci of number minus 1 plus number minus 2. Okay, and that's all. Have to change this to Fibonacci Fibonacci. Okay, this is one Fibonacci, and this one will be changed to Fibonacci as well, FIB. Okay, that's all. So I will run. It will be very pretty easy, right? You can just simply change 22, 22 all number. Number is 20, sorry, it is 676, 67. Okay, 5 first, run. 5 is 5, 6 will be 8, 6. Is 8. That's right. 7 is 13. Okay, this one is very easy, right? You can just write 1, 2, 3, 4. Just only 4 lines, of course, right? For solving the Fibonacci, right? I ask you, if you want to find a Fibonacci, but you will use the iteration, how can we do? Please help me. Okay, I will change this to from long integer into just integer. Okay, 5 Fibonacci, fib. How can we do? For me, I will use array. I will use array to keep the step. Or I have to use, if I don't want to use array, how can I do? Integer. Because we are going to find the previous two values, right? So we have to find the Fibonacci minus 1 and Fibonacci minus 2. Okay. If number, okay, we can use the same thing, right? If number is equal to 1 or 0, you will return number. And then stop. Else, else what? Else you can set Fibonacci minus 0, Fibonacci minus 2 is equal to 0, and Fibonacci minus 1 equal to 1, right? And then use for loop. For loop will start from when I is equal to I from 0, I from 2 number. Okay, if I is equal to 2, so what should we do? Result is equal to plus, right? Result can be set to 0. Result plus Fibonacci 1 plus Fibonacci minus 2, right? But it is not yet to the results, right? So what should we do is Fibonacci minus 1 will be the result of the previous step, and Fibonacci minus 2 will be Fibonacci 1 minus 1, right? So, but before you substitute Fibonacci minus 1 with the result, the current result, so you may have to move the Fibonacci 1 to Fibonacci 2 and result to Fibonacci 1, okay? What is the result for the Fibonacci 7? I remember that, sorry, 5 will be 5. Keep them. Oh. Fibo. Okay, I change the name to Fibo because the name of the function and the name of the variable are the same. Okay, and run. Okay, 5. It seems to be correct. 5, 8, and 13. Okay, 13. Okay. Do you follow me? The first thing is you have to find the result of the Fibonacci minus 1 and Fibonacci minus 2, right? I use the value or the variable Fibonacci underscore 1 to represent Fibonacci minus 1, and Fibonacci underscore 2 will represent the Fibonacci minus 2, n minus 2. And then before we will move to the next iteration, we need to find the next Fibonacci, right? You have to substitute Fibonacci minus 2 by the previous Fibonacci minus 1. And then the Fibonacci minus 1 will be the value of the result of the previous step. So you can get the Fibonacci minus 1 and Fibonacci 2 for the step of 3. And then you add them up and assign to the result. And then you do the same thing like this until you can get, you can go to the number or the given number, and that's all. So this is the iteration function for the Fibonacci, okay? But you can see that if you know the formula or the recursive formula for the Fibonacci function, it will be just only 4 steps or 4 lines of code. But if you want to use the iterative step, right, it will be longer, okay? It will be longer. So it's up to you, right? You can use any functions. What will be the kinds of the recursion? Okay. Okay, I think you all can understand about how to write the recursive function. That's not the difficult things, right? So the next trick that I would like to teach you in this class is about, if you could remember about pass by value and pass by reference, right? There are some students ask me about, is it, okay, I use a swap function, if you could remember. Right, if I have two integer, right, integer a and b, right, and I would like to swap a and b, right, a and b, right, if a is equal to maybe 10 and then b is equal to 20, okay, for the easy one, so I have to use the ampersand, right. Okay, this swap function will be the void swap function. And I give you the idea, if you want to write the pass by reference or pass by address of the function, maybe you have to start from, okay, written in terms of the pass by value first, x and y. You don't have to put the star or asterisk here, okay? And then we have integer. Temp t, right? Okay, if you want to swap it, you can use t is equal to, this is a pattern you have to remember, t is equal to x, right? X assigned to t to temp first, and then x equal to y, and y is equal to temp. You have to use this loop, right? X to t, y to x, and t to y. Or you can think like this, t, x, x, y, y, t. Something like this, but because you send ampersand A and ampersand B here, you have to change this to star and star, and any place of X you have to put star in front of it, and Y also, right? The name of this, right? Actually, in this function, X is an address. X is an address. So when you put asterisk or star in front of X, it will be the value of that address. Or we call dereferencing. Referencing. Okay, this is the name, right? You may have to remember it's dereferencing. This is a pass by reference, right? Pass by reference, or sometimes we call it as a pass by address. Address means the address in memory. Mean address in memory, right? We call by reference. Reference means the address in memory. Okay, and if you use X, right? If you use t is equal to x, x is equal to y, right? It will return the address of x and to y. That is not correct. Because we are going to deal with the value at that address. At that address. So you need to dereferencing. The process of dereferencing in C programming is just to put the star sign in front of the address. So you will get the value of at that address, the value of the variable at that address, the value of the variable at that address. Okay, so this is called the dereferencing. But in this way, maybe you confused. And I found out that in the POSN competition, the Olympiad competition, right? They will not use this one. Maybe it is of using the pointer. We are going to talk about the pointer in the next week class, okay? But today, I would like to give you a tricky things. If you want to avoid to use the pass by reference or the dereferencing, you can use the concept of array, okay? So, okay, instead of use this, I would swap to, and I, okay, suppose I have array. I want to swap to array. I use array, ARR, and I have two value. Right. And two value, I will initialize it as the 10 and 20, 10 and 20. So I use swap to instead, swap to, okay? And then I pass this array to this function. So this function, you will receive the array of integer. Array of integer, so I use integer, array of integer, and then I use a, like this. Suppose I don't know in advance the number of elements in this, but I know in advance that there are only two elements in this array, and this one, we know two integer value. Natural and advanced values in this array. Okay. So in this array. Thank you. Okay. So what shall we do? It's very easy, right? The first element is 10, right? You can refer to the element for the first array is. Okay, I use first. Integer first is equal to A0 because the index in C programming, the first index of C programming is 0, and the second. Okay, I want to make it shorter, but I use like this. I want it to be the same length at first, so I use scond. A1. Okay, and then so I want A1 to be first. I want to change A1. Swap, okay, A1 to be first. Okay, I move assign first to A1 and I assign second to A0. If I use like this array, right? So you can use A. And bracket like this, square bracket like this, or you can use a or pass by reference like this. Okay, you can do the same. Okay, this one is easier. Okay, do you think the value of the things that you mentioned in this array will change to 20 and 10? We have not yet, right? We have to print it out. So, first is equal to percent sign D, and second is equal to percent sign D, right? And then should be array 0, right? First will be array 0, and then second will be array 1. If the swap to is correct, right? it will print out first is equal to 20 and second is equal to 10. Am I right? Right. Otherwise, it will be okay. I will print it out first before swap and after swap. Okay. Run. Before swap, right? A, the first array is 10, the second element is 20. But after we go to the swap to function, this is a tricky function, right? We will use array to. Okay, for this one, right? It will be easier than this one, right? This one you may have to put the star sign in front of the variable, right? That is a pass by reference. That is an address, right? You are going to you do the dereferencing, okay? Next time when I use star something, right? I will sometimes say it as a dereferencing, right? So it will refer to this interchangeably. But by using this web swap too, right? You can make the use of array, right? And then you pass the array to this one. To pass the array will be similar to pass by reference. When you change anything inside the array, it will also affect to the value or the elements in the array in the main program as well, the main function as well. So when you swap this, right, A0 and A1, right? You may use temp only as well. Okay, I use this one. Maybe I want to make it shorter. I use integer temp, right, is equal to A0. And then A0 is equal to A1. So it's very pretty, very easy, right? You don't have to be confused about dereferencing things, right? And then A1 is equal to 10, right? You can do the same thing like this, right? You don't have to think about the asterisk sign. You can just simply use this one. Okay, this swap function is also working. Okay. Pretty easy. Okay, this program for swap. Pass by. This is just a technique, okay? Even I teach you, right? But maybe you have to try to use this swap by using the dereference as well, right? Even it is how to use the pointer, right? You may have to use the pointer in the future, right? But in this way, it is a tricky way, right? I just want to teach you because you are going to be the future programmer, right? You have to know every trick or everything that can help you to write a program easier, okay? Anything else? Okay, I try to use this one. Oh, the next thing is that you have to know how to write an array of character. Array of character. Have you finished this? Okay, if you finish this, I will start with the new things. Array of character is, you have known in advance that array of character supposed name, right? Name 30, right? We have to allocate the 30 space of characters for this name, right? And we have to, the maximum number of the name is 29. And the last character we reserve to the \0 to represent the end of this string, right? So this one can be called string, right? In other languages like Fortran or Pascal languages, right? You will use the data type string directly. But in C programming, we don't have the string data type. So you have to use the character array of character. And for the array of character, right, if you want to deal with the string, you may have to use integer, oh no, include string.h. string.h like this, right? If you want to do, if you want to use string compare to compare to string, right? Or you use string copy if you want to copy one string to another, right? You have to include string.h. For example, if I write this, right, it can be the name, character, name two. I can also like this, right? Name two. I can initialize it to be CPE KMUTT, right? And then if you want to compare two string, normally I get S name one. Okay, maybe I will print out in F. Enter a name. Okay, enter a name and get S, right? Normally we will not use get S, right? There is a specific way to get the string input, right? From the screen, right? But for the sake of simplicity, I use get S, but we have something that I cannot remember it. I will ask TA again, right? There is a specific way to get the string, but I think this one is also okay. If you want to compare two string, right? I want to maybe to make sure that I type CPE hyphen KMUTT, right? If I cannot compare like this, name one is equal to name two. No, I cannot do this, right? Okay, maybe I will try that. Pin F, match, M-A-T-C-H, match, if it is match. If not, else, I can use the parentheses on, I can use the braces or not match. Okay, then I run. Get something is not possible. Name. Ooh. Name. We cannot use. DP, okay, deprecate. Deprecate means, thank you very much. It seems like I'm very old. In the past, I can use get S, right? But nowadays we cannot use it because it deprecate. So I cannot use this. So, okay, I will forget this, right? I don't have to use this. I will ask my TA again. I don't remember. Okay, I will assign the value to here. Okay, maybe CPE. Okay, this seems to be exactly the same, right? CPE can be, I just copy it. It's supposed to print matched, okay? By using this one. Okay, I run it. Not match. What's happened? You may find out this problem or this trouble in the future, but I don't want to face a problem like this, right? So I will tell it. The reason why name one is not equal name two, even it is exactly the same, because in, okay, when you compare this, right, it will compare the address of name one and name two. This one means comparing the addresses of name one and name two. That's why not match is printed out. Okay, so this is not what we want to do, right? We want to compare two string, right? So why? Maybe someone asked me why it is an address, right? It's supposed to be the string, because as I just told you in the previous program, right? When you talk about the array of something, right? We will think about in C programming, it will kept in terms of the reference or the address of that variable. If you want to compare two things, you can use string strcmp function, string compare. Name one and name two. Okay. Supposed to print match, right? Not match again. What's happened? Because the string compare will return if it is matched, exactly the same matched, name one and name two is equivalent, the result of string compare will return zero. Zero. That's why I write if string compare only, if string compare name one and name two, because the result is zero, so the not match will be printed out. So if you want to print it out matched, you need to type string compare name one and name two, and the result is exactly the same, that is equal zero. So now these two string will say matched. In the past, when I was studying C programming, I said, oh my God, it doesn't make sense. It doesn't make any sense. Okay, to write string compare, this means the same. This means the same, right? So in order to, okay, avoid the misunderstanding, right? I normally like it like this. I suggest you another one, because if it is matched, right, it will turn zero. So I use not string compare. Not string compare means false and not false will be true. So this can be used interchangeably, not string compare. Not match. Okay. So this is how to use string compare. Character name tree 30. Suppose I want to copy name two to name three. I use strcpy, string copy. From name to name three. I'm not sure I have to name two to name three. Name two to name three or name three to name two. I think it's like this. When I want to print a string, I use percent sign S and then name three. Okay, this is the weird thing of C programming. If you want to copy name 2 to name 3, you have to use name 2. You have to use something copy name 3, name 2. This one means copy name 2 to name 3. Okay? If you do in opposite, name 2 to name 3. You can see that the garbage will be printed out. It means that garbage will copy to name 2 and name 2 will be garbage as well instead of CPEKMUTT, right? So you have to use, please remember name 3, name 2. That is to copy name 2, string name 2 to name 3. Okay? Even we have string compare and string copy, I want you to do this lab, right? I will copy this one to you first. I would like you to write two function. Okay, it may be void, integer, string. STR, but C-O-M-P-P-A-R-E, string compare to name one. And name 2. Write string compare and string copy without using string.h. Delete it. String copy by yourself. Okay, how can we do? We can also use string length as well. If you want to know the length, string length, S-T-R-L-E-N, right? To know the length of name 3. Printf. The length of person sign S, right? Is person sign D, right? Name 3. Right after we copy, right? String length name 3, right? Will be return the length of this name 3. Oops. I delete include string str.h, right? We are going to use the string length, so we have to use string.h. unknown type name true. อ๋อค่ะอุ๊ย char นาย cpe hyphen kmutt โอเคนายโอเคSo my homework is that try to write three function integer string length str leng th okay three three functionsThank you, Natcha. Okay, three functions. Okay, try to write your own functions. This is the passion, right? If when I was young, right, when I was studying C programming, right, I try to write my own functions because I want to check for my skill, my C programming skill. And then I have to know. After you finish this, you will know exactly how the string compare, string copy, and string link.Do okay, so this is my homework. Okay, and before you leave, right, please type 5 in order to check for the class attendance today. And then, thank you for attending today class. Today class, I think you have fun with my class today, right? I type the program, and then you can know how to write the program.How to, this is my C programming style of writing program. Okay, so enjoy your meal, right? And then if you have any question, please feel free to ask me. Okay, bye bye. Have a good time.
อาจารย์ครับ
ครับ
คือแบบว่า